We can put it another way. Within you lies hidden a giant, the being of the next evolutionary stage that comes after man and stands above him and is as superior to him as we are to the monkeys. An immortal, invulnerable, invincible being of spirit that has much higher abilities and far greater possibilities for development than a material creature. The new man of the coming sixth race is already laid out within you, just as the germ of the animal is already present in the plant, and the germ of man in the animal. The overman of whom Nietzsche speaks prophetically is slumbering within you. For the time being, however, he is still in the stage of an infant who wishes to grow greater at all means. This is the hero you dreamed of as a child. That is why you love stories about saints and heroes so much. They make a string within you resound. You feel the titan within you who longs to come to light. You are a giant among dwarfs, like Gulliver among the Lilliputians. Meanwhile, the giant is still fettered. You have to release him so that he can unfold his power and carry out his work on earth. An ancient symbol of this mighty being incarcerated within you is the genie whom Aladdin frees from the magic lamp so that he might serve him. You are to reveal this being, not the old man or its even lower precursor, the animal. Therefore, instead of transformation or bringing to life, we may also say, you bring out the potential that lies hidden within you. If you do not feel your soul, or do not want anything to know about it, at any rate, this potential within you, you can sense, and how it downright urges for revelation. You are still a caterpillar, which is to become something much greater and more beautiful, namely a butterfly. Finally, we want to express the facts in purely scientific terms. Your supratemporal individuality, your fiery body, is a being of a higher vibration than your physical body. You have used the term vibration many times before, but I am not yet really clear about what you mean by that. Well, we had already said there is no spirit and no matter, but only spirit matter. Matter is spirit matter of low. Spirit is spirit matter of high vibration. Take an example. Water of low vibration is ice. Water of high vibration is vapor. What does that mean for us humans? As long as we are in a state of low vibration, we are living in the physical body only. When we increase our vibration, the subtle body forms. in a state of highest vibration, we can appear with and consciously use the fiery body, the soul, the eternal individuality. Just like another item with other properties is created when you heat ice, namely first water and then steam. Of course, in humans, high vibration does not mean physical heat, but fieriness in the spiritual sense. Decreasing physicality while increasing refinement and spirituality. That is still pretty abstract. Can you give an example from everyday life? When the fire of enthusiasm for a great selfless work burns within you, you are in a state of high vibration. When you are irritated or aggressive, your being vibrates low at the level of the body, selfish and unloving, bound to the lower physical self. More about this will be found in the broadcasting fiery condition. Let us memorize. The transformation, the bringing to life of the eternal individuality takes place when you increase the vibration of your being. Thereby, you grow from the old material man to the new man of spirit. Now your soul begins to live. Urusvati, Helena Rurich, understood that people can be transformed through better vibrations. The upcoming sixth race consists of men of spirit. Now we assemble the spirits of the sixth race, and Agni Yoga is the call. The difference between the old and the new man is not external, as between quadrupeds and bipeds. It is only in the degree of vibration. High vibration is a state of purity, vitality, joy of being, solemnity, serenity, peace of mind, enthusiasm, and freedom from desires. In such a moment, your fiery body is existent. When the vibration drops, you immediately turn from a spiritual back to a physical being. It should not be thought that in his consciousness an Ahat could lose sight of the guiding will even for an instant. He proves to be a simple mortal if he does not always solemnly bear the chalice of achievement. As vapor becomes water and eventually ice, when its vibration decreases. The essential nature of man can be transmuted by the invocation of better vibrations. Only such a reminder will give man access to a higher status. At the present time, humanity is found to be continually in the vibrations of the lower spheres. Therefore, the lower manas motivates life. Now, let us return to the question, how can you bring to life your soul, the giant hidden within you? Your perishable personality was laid for you into the cradle. It is largely determined by your physical body, inheritance, and the society into which you were born. You are by birth, man or woman, big or small, German, American or Russian, Jew, Muslim, Hindu or Christian. As opposed to that, your eternal individuality is not bestowed on you as a gift. It is still faceless, almost non-existent. Your true self is still very small, weak, and barely formed. Your task, the task of every man who wishes to grow greater and exploit the potential lying within him, is therefore you have yet to shape your soul. A stone has not yet developed a body of feelings, a plant not yet a body of thoughts. Likewise, today's man of the fifth race has not nearly molded the fiery body at all. This is the task we are to work on these days. Does not that mean aiming too high? No. We had already said and need to emphasize once again very clearly, in the circle of evolution and involution, we are at present in round 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, of the fourth, the earthly cycle. Here, in the fourth race, Atlantis, the development of the lower mortal tetrad of man should already have been largely completed. In today's fifth race, the development of manas, straight knowledge, or knowledge of the heart, the first stage of the higher immortal triad of man, is already on the schedule. Then, in the sixth and seventh races, and in rounds 5, 6, and 7, with Buddhi, higher love, and Atma, divine spirit, the two other aspects of our higher eternal self follow. It is of the utmost importance that you realize, as far as your supra-temporal individuality, the fiery body, can be formed on earth at all, its creation must begin now. We are in default. The sixth race is about to arise, and the tasks of the fifth race are not yet completed. The development of manas, the knowledge of the heart, has barely begun. We continue to lag behind the course of evolution. However, the three higher principles of your eternal individuality will only be fully shaped on other planets in the fifth, sixth, and seventh cycle of the ascending arc. It will take billions of years for the fiery body to be completely formed at the end of the seventh cycle, shortly before returning to the highest point of the spiral evolution. For the time being, your soul exists only as a germ, as a latent potential. It is in an unprocessed raw state. An unsatisfactory low state. I am untreated raw material. Yes, your true nature is as yet almost non-existent. Just think, your true self, the more important spiritual part of your nature, is at present in an embryonic state only. We can compare it to a baby who is not yet aware of himself and still has to learn some skills such as grasping, walking, and speaking before we can truly call him a human being. One of the key points of Agni Yoga regarding our topic is for visions to happen, the fiery body has to be sufficiently formed. Of course, the fiery body always exists, but it may be in a chaotic and unconscious state. Your eternal individuality exists, but as a potential only. And yet, it does not exist as long as this potential is not unearthed and becomes a reality. Nature does not make leaps. We have to make the spirit man hidden within us grow out of us step by step in the course of a completely natural process. The meaning of your life, your life's task, is become who you are, a man of spirit.